From the JAMA Network, this is JAMA Clinical Reviews, interviews and ideas about innovations in medicine, science, and clinical practice.
Hello, and welcome to this JAMA Clinical Reviews podcast. I'm Dr. Kirsten Bibbins-Domingo, and I'm the editor-in-chief of JAMA and the JAMA Network. I'm joined today by Dr. Lee Lee, a family physician and the Walter M. Seward Professor and the Chair of Family Medicine at the University of Virginia School of Medicine. He is also the co-leader of the Cancer Prevention and Population Health Program at the UVA Comprehensive Cancer Center. Dr. Lee is a member of the U.S. Preventive Services Task Force, and he's joining us here today to discuss the new update to the recommendation statement from the U.S. Preventive Services Task Force on interventions to prevent falls in older adults. JAMA has published this recommendation statement and the evidence report on which the task force recommendation statement is based. Dr. Lee, thank you for joining me here again today to discuss the work of the task force.
Thank you to have me here to talk about this important topic.
Wonderful. Well, I like to begin with giving you the opportunity to give us the high-level summary of this recommendation statement. What is the task force recommending with regards to fall prevention in older adults?
Absolutely. So falls are the leading cause of injury in older adults. It can lead to serious disability and even to death. So to prevent falls in older adults, the task force recommends structured exercise program to patients live at home who are aged 65 years and older, who are more likely to fall. So this is a big recommendation. The task force also recommends the health professionals should talk to the patient about whether additional interventions that tailored to the individual patient might be helpful to reduce the risk of falls.
Fantastic. So I think let's start at the beginning. So this is a big problem. Can you give us an idea of how big a problem this is in older adults and who specifically is at risk?
Yes, this recommendation applies to older adults. We call this community dwelling adults who are at risk of increased fall. By community dwelling adults, we mean that those folks who are older adults who are aged 65 and older, who live at home, not in a nursing home, or not in an institutional care facility. So this applies to this patient population. Indeed, falls is a big concern for elder patients. As we age, the risk of fall increases. For example, in the previous year, about one in every four older adults reported fall, and one in 10 reported they have fall-related injuries in the past. So this is a big concern for elder patients.
So I just want to underscore how important this is. This is people who are living at home. This isn't people who are already in a type of care facility or a nursing home. These are older adults who are living at home. But what you've said is about a quarter of them last year fell. And many of these are serious falls.
That's correct. It's about 27% of older adults who are 65 years old reporting fall in the previous year, and one out of 10 reported a fall-related injuries in the previous year.
Right. So a big problem. The good news in this recommendation is there are things that clinicians and patients can talk about regarding how to prevent falls. And in fact, the exercise recommendation is a B recommendation, which means the balance of benefits versus risk is really clearly favors benefit here. So tell us more about that. What type of exercise does the evidence support?
So indeed, so the task force reviewed and evaluated current evidence, scientific evidence, to look at ways to prevent falls in old adult patients. And we find evidence to support that exercise program provide moderate amount of benefit to older adults live at home or who are at risk. So that's a big recommendation. We recommend this prevention to all adults who are 65 years and older, live at home, who are at risk for a fall. So that's in terms of what's the best exercise program, we call this structured exercise program, meaning that it's a supervised or guided exercise program, either done in a group setting or individually. This can be done at home or in a facility. But in terms of what's the most effective exercise intervention, as we look at data, really there's no clear cut. What are the main components or the best practice in terms of exercise intervention? That being said, the study we reviewed usually include components like this, like a gait or the way the patient walk, the balance, as well as functional training. That's the components. Other components that report in the study include strength, resistance training, flexibility, or endurance training. So at this point, yes, we do not have specific data to tell us what is the best exercise intervention. But that being said, the message that exercise intervention works for most for patients who are 65 years old, this should be recommended for all adults who are age 65 years old, live at home, and at a risk of falling.
Wonderful. So I'm sure we'd like to always know more about the specific types of exercise. But what I hear you saying, and I read in the recommendation, is that the evidence is consistent with respect to the benefits of a structured exercise program. And it seems like that might be consistent with a range of options for the way that exercise program is delivered.
That's correct.
So let's turn then to the other intervention the task force looked at, which is titled multifactorial intervention. So we'd like to know a little bit more about what factors are in this multifactorial intervention that the task force is looking at.
Sure. So task force also look at multifactorial intervention. Basically, multifactorial intervention is a way of assess the risk of fall, that address the risk of fall in the personalized approach to it. So basically, this is done using first a clinician will see a patient, comes an old adult patient, come see them. They will complete assessment of the risk based on the factors such as the age of patient and history of fall in the past and the circumstance surrounding the fall if they have in the past, any other medical comorbidities or medical conditions, whether they take any medication that may actually increase chance of fall, and also look at their home, neighborhood, workplace, or community living environment, such as slippery flooring and the loose concrete, and also medication use as well as drug use or alcohol use, and also the patient's own preference and values. We all take this consideration to assess a fall. Then, based on what we find from this assessment, we develop a plan and intervention that will help address this risk factor for this individual patient. So we call this multifactorial intervention.
So it sounds like that is a more comprehensive look at the patient and the factors that might lead to falls and a way of tailoring a more comprehensive set of recommendations. But here, the recommendation is a C. So tell me why this has a different grade.
In this case, we look at the scientific data, current scientific data, to see any ways to help prevent falls in older adults. And for exercise intervention, we find solid evidence supporting that exercise intervention is beneficial for older adults. For multifactorial intervention, we only find that there's a small benefit for some people, not all. So that's why we encourage the clinicians to engage a dialogue, conversation with the individual patient to decide together whether the tailored approach for intervention will be beneficial for this specific patient in terms of reduce their risk of falling.
I see. You're a family physician. What's your approach in clinical practice?
So indeed, I'm a practice family physician, and as a family doc, we see patients from all ages, including a majority of our practice, including old adults as well. So in our practice, we usually address issue of fall as part of our annual wellness visit. That's part of the assessment. It usually takes about 45, 1 hour. We'll complete a very comprehensive assessment of patient's health and risk, including falling risk. Then we address this accordingly. Of course, for those folks live at home and who are at risk, we definitely recommend a structured exercise intervention. But for patients who has concerns or has symptoms about specific concerns, we will listen, we'll address the specific concerns and to come up with a solution for that.
Okay, so it sounds like I'm hearing a very clear message about the structured exercise, But additional recommendations to do as clinicians should always do, talk with patients to think about other aspects about tailoring interventions that might reduce their risk of falls. What other recommendations does the task force have on the books that relate to fall prevention, and what should our listeners be aware about there?
So this new recommendation replaces the task force 2018 recommendation on the topic of falls prevention. For the most part, this new recommendation is consistent with the 2018 recommendation, except this new recommendation focuses on exercise and multifactor intervention, does not address the previous recommendation has vitamin D supplements used for fall prevention. So vitamin D supplements or in combination with calcium now currently being reviewed, the evidence being reviewed and assessed by the task force in a separate topic.
Okay, and is there a final recommendation on the use of calcium vitamin D?
So we're in the process of reviewing the current evidence related to vitamin D or calcium supplements to prevent falls in the elderly. And the final research plan has been posted in April 2024. And it will take about 2 years for the task force to finish a recommendation from time zero to finish the published recommendation statement.
Okay, so the message there is stay tuned. But in the meantime, there is something that clinicians can recommend to patients that patients can engage in and more discussion to address this very important issue. What's the final take-home that you would like to leave our listeners with?
Yes, so fall is a big concern for elder patients, and the task force review showing that exercise intervention works for all adults who age 65 and older would definitely recommend clinicians offer the exercise intervention to older adults who live at home who are at risk of fall. And also, we said exercise also has other benefits as well. It can benefit from heart disease, it reduces risk of hypertension, reduces risk of diabetes. So we definitely recommend that. And for other patients who has other concerns, we clinicians should work with patient together, engage a shared decision-making dialogue, decide whether additional intervention tailored to the patient themselves will help reduce the risk.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for helping us to understand this recommendation statement, Dr. Lee.
Thank you for having me.
I've been speaking with Dr. Lee Lee, a family physician and a member of the U.S. Preventive Services Task Force, about the new update to the Task Force recommendation statement on interventions to prevent falls in older adults. This episode was produced by Daniel Morrow at the JAMA Network. To follow this and other JAMA Network podcasts, please visit us online at jamanetworkaudio.com. Thanks for listening.